Hello from the world headquarters for the Hanging with Herky Empire.
Here we are, trying to get readjusted to getting back into our groove. Oh!
Whoa, Herky almost fell down.
Sorry. Anyway, so this week's video coming up is about going to pick up our van, right? Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay. So anyway, the reasoning for our van is I have my 2014 Ford Escape, and we have put how many miles on it in 3 years? It's been to Florida like four or five times, yeah. California twice,
put like Wyoming. 30,000 miles a year on it.
Yeah. So, and I love my car, and I don't want to just
wear it out.
Right.
Yeah.
Drive it into the ground. So, here's the deal with the van. So we are going to just pull a trailer with it, right? Mm-hmm. But it only has two seats. Ed has already taken it to
our recycle center,
and gotten rid of the back seats. So in it will be what we used to put in the back of my car. So that would be the two refrigerators, our lawn chairs, the table that we set up as our kitchen, our ARB room, its rug.
Our gear.
Right, but we are, however, going to have an extra potty back there because when we were coming back from California from our sabbatical and COVID hit and everything was shut down, it was hard to find a place to go to the bathroom, so we were getting in the back of the trailer, which is fine, but there's no lights and it's hard to navigate.
Yeah, so that's one of the main things that we really wanted to do. We wanted to get out, especially Nancy, wanted to get out of going into public restrooms and things like that. So, and the other thing we found out is, you know, sometimes when we're out in national parks and we pull off on a scenic overlook and, you know, we want to spend some time there just looking at nature and that. And then if you have to go to the restroom or something, Herky just brought his toy over for me to play with. If you have to go to the restroom or something, we got to pack everything up and go back. Mm-hmm. So this would allow us just some really flexibility.
If the camper's like at a camp or
that's
something.
That's right.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
So there's a lot of people sent in a lot of comments about portable kitchens and things like that. This is going to be strictly an adventure van.
We are going to be set up to the fact that when we travel, I get on my knees and lean over the back of the seat and fix our lunch while we're driving. So this way, this will also allow me to get up, go to the back of the van while we're still driving and fix our lunch. Mm-hmm. Also, I don't know if you remember last winter when we went to Vincennes, Indiana,
right. And
it was sleeting and just really bad. And we were getting right into the car with our wet clothes, umbrella, raincoats. So this way we can get in the side door of the van, take off our wet rain gear,
right,
and then get into our seats and we're not going to be sitting in water.
Yeah. So across the back, we're not really making a bed in this.
No.
There'll be a bench across the back.
Small.
So we have shelves. There'll be a bench across the side, on the driver's side, to where we can get in there. We can sit down and change our shoes and things like that.
Right.
And
put our hiking shoes on.
Or our hiking poles and shoes
will be in there too.
Directly in front of you will be the shelves and everything with our gear on it and everything. The other thing that we want is we want the car to be cool and we want it to be hot and warm in the winter when we come back. So we're going to install probably a Max Air or a Fantastic Fan in there so that if we don't take Herky and he wants to stay in the car, we can have a fan running in that. Now remember, we have a portable system that we can monitor the temperature and that. So don't worry about Herky. He'll be fine.
No, we would never do anything to hurt Herky.
So the other thing I'm looking at is what they call diesel heaters. Hopefully sometime in the next few months, I'll install a heater in there that will run off of diesel. so that when we are out and about looking around, the van will still stay warm, so we come back to a warm vehicle.
Yeah, because most of our travel seems to be in the winter.
Yeah, we're doing a lot of road tripping, and this will really...
Will stay packed.
Right, right.
Right now, I mean, that trailer is ready to go at a moment's notice, but we have to put what we need into the car. Mm-hmm. And this way, the van will stay packed. All we'll have to do is load coolers.
Right.
Food into the coolers. They'll stay in there as well.
We hope to have an electrical system in there where that all stays plugged in and everything. We will not be putting solar on this because, we'll be able to charge our batteries from the alternator. So
there's an opportunity perhaps of us getting a battery pack.
That's correct. A lithium pack.
So we're waiting to hear on that still.
That'll probably be more along the lines of what we do. We'll probably put a lithium power pack in there. And that should run everything we need to run.
Right. Keep our batteries charged for the GoPro, our phones charged, your iPad, things like that.
That's another thing, too, is like when we're filming and that, we have to dig through the bags to get our chargers and our cameras and everything.
And they usually fall what we call
the no man's land.
No man's land, the dead zone in between the seat and the console of my car. You cannot get that back out.
Our batteries drop down in there all the time, and then you gotta unload a bunch of stuff, and it's so hard to get stuff that falls in between the seats. So in our new van, we'll have a section there just for our camera gear where it'll all be set up, and it can be on chargers and everything. So
we should be more organized.
I think so. We will be cooking, but our cooking gear will be in the van. And we'll be able to pull out if we want to cook while we're out.
But it would pull out of the van.
Right, it's not going to be
in the van.
It's not going to be in the van. Get the case out with
a slide out the back door.
Right, just a little shelf there where we can set things on. Nothing elaborate.
Well, okay, I got to tell this story. So I bought Ed a Blackstone for Christmas, like a 17-inch, a portable one. And so he's outside working on the van, and the UPS guy comes up and says, "Hey, I think this is your Christmas gift."
So I already know what I'm getting for Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, so I bet a lot of these are wondering why the Astro van, why the 1999 Astro van.
1999. Our antique van.
Antique van. So I got to tell you that we in the past year, we kind of got fascinated with overlanders.
You have.
Yeah. So I've been watching a lot of overlanders. Now, I'm not wanting to go to that extreme, and there's no way Nancy's going to that extreme either. But
I do a lot of your craziness. But
I've noticed a lot of these guys buy these all-wheel drive Astro vans. And last year especially, we hit some really bad weather where we... if you guys remember, we were out in like Kansas or something. It was snowing.
We slid
down that hill and everything. So I really started looking for either four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. And the more I read on these Astro vans, I guess really for about the past 2 years, I've been looking at these Astro vans. And they're absolutely bulletproof. This one's got 140,000 miles on it. And I am positive I can get that thing to go to 250, 300. And it has no rust on it. So asking why the Astro van, it has plenty of room. It's kind of boxy. A lot of overlanders are using it. It has all-wheel drive.
It was cheaper than what I wanted.
Yeah.
What did I want?
Well, you wanted the Ford Transit Connect. Yeah. The small Ford Transit. That was another thing. It's like, why? I didn't want to spend $30,000 on a platform that we were just gonna burn up in just a few years. So,
and he's cheap.
So, I got this for a couple $1,000, and
Wait, you see the new tires we had put on it.
So we're gonna lift it a little bit. We already
They're purdy.
We got some all-terrain tires on it. So anyway, that is why this platform, and this allows us to do some Forest Service roads too. So. When we get back out west and we get on BLM land like we've done in the past, it'll go over those a little bit better. So anyway,
in my little Ford Escape.
Yeah. So anyway, the other thing too is it's a $2,000 car, that, you know, I'm very mechanical, so I've been able to fix up. And we laughed and said, if we got someplace and it died on us, we could just leave it.
We'll just buy something else, and come home.
So anyway,
that's just the way we roll.
That's why the Astrovan, I think you're going to like the way we fix it.
I like the way you fix it.
Yeah, that's the other thing too.
Right now it's really dirty.
Right now we've stripped everything out. And,
did we mention it was a chicken coop?
Yeah, we're going to take that thing on a few drives around town. In fact, this weekend we're going to do a short road trip before we do the build out, just to make sure this is exactly what we want to do. But anyway, that's our midweek chat, and it's about why we're doing the van. This Sunday you'll see a video coming out of us going and buying the van and what it looks like. But stay tuned. Every week is not going to be the van build.
Don't get excited, because it's nothing special.
I mean, because of COVID, we are having a little trouble getting out like we used to. But every week is not going to be a van build.
No, we'll have it
in there, and when I get done, I'll put it in a playlist. So
yeah.
Anyway,
like the pop-up.
For right now, we got to take Herky outside.
We got to wake him up first.
He fell asleep again.
Herky, get up. Okay, here we go.
All right. Thanks for watching. Hey, if you have any questions or anything you want to reach out to us, we have that email at hangingwithherky@gmail.com.
Herky also has a Facebook account. Yes, you do.
You can follow Herky on Facebook and see what he's up to. But we will see you on Sunday.
Bye now.